Oh, I'm Eddie, and today I will show you how I turn from this car to this. There's going to be a magic picture that is not here yet, but that will be where the video will be uploaded. This! Let's see what I'm going to do this time. For today's building, I will convert this El Camino for my next Castlands game. It will take place in 5 days, so I really have to hurry. In my 30 years, I couldn't care less about cars. I know nothing at all. Literally nothing. So, my limited experience is based on Mad Max, Need for Speed, and Pimp My Ride. Before I can do anything to this car, I have to remove the rivet so I can take apart the four pieces. And because I will use a Dremel, remember to
watch out
for fingers. After drilling the rivet, you can easily remove the four parts. While inside here, you can see me struggling like a monkey, just because I am one. Oh, I did it. The color scheme was supposed to be easy. Black for the seats and the back of the trunk, and the matte varnish on the external parts. My idea was to try and use the original paint job and only weather it down later. Man, this is going to be a roller coaster, you have no idea. Here I was checking my bag of weapons. Half is 3D printed, the other half instead is from Warhammer 40k. This is really a fun part because I can finally toy around with all the different weapons I have around. I really like this first combo, but I tried more and discarded it because I'm a chaotic beast. I just don't work as I'm intended to, my mind just drifts constantly. So, after a bazooka, rocket launcher, two miniguns, whatever, I found... this one! Sylvester Stallone will be proud of what will be of this car. With a plastic bit from an oil bottle cap, I made a barrel and decided to lay the turret on it. This is my definition of poor hammer. I tried to open the super glue, but guess what? The cap was glued on itself. Well, it still works, so who am I to judge? Now, please, 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 watch how dumb I am. This is the one I just glued. And what the hell am I picking up? Another one. Come on, Eddie. I didn't even notice it. I'm just holding it. And the other one is laying in front of me. Okay, yeah, this moment, now. Yeah, it's about time. This is a cool piece I found on the ground. No idea what it is. The shape was similar to those engines coming out of the car, so I tried to mimic it. Quick snap, quick detailing, and quick realization that it will be in the way of the rifle. Ah!
Disappointed!
With some prosciutto package, I tried to make some reinforcements for the wheels. Just some panels on the side is enough to cover them. With some super glue, I'm locking them in place. Fucking lock in any fucking place! And you know what? Screw all this shit! This is why! The frustration! Everything was messy, everything was covered with super glue. Fuck all of this. So, I literally dunked the car in the nitrous solvent and removed everything. So, everything I did so fast, it was totally pointless. But at least I had a new canvas. The red net is from a bag of tangerines. I use it to make it the windshield, while inside the cloth on the roof is from a Warhammer 40k tank. Well, I had to prime everything again, so brown spray can for the base, then blue as a main color and white for the stripe in the middle. I quickly taped it, hoping for the best, and I was wrong. Then I went to the balcony, forgetting totally to use the hairspray first, so I could remove later on the paint and show the rust behind. Eddie, come on, Eddie, pull it together. While removing the tape, I realized the mistake, but it was too late to go back, so... Look how gloss it is! This spray is for professional use, it has even the waxing effect. So I just tape it back and spray paint with the white this time. This is the best. This is me trying to convince myself the paint will chip like in the previous build. Man, it won't. Not a bit. This paint is stuck for good. This paint is stronger than some people friendship. It just doesn't care. It just doesn't. Look at it. I tried to scratch it, I tried to scrub it. What a waste of time, what a... Oh god, another failure. This is my favorite color ever. This warm brown is the solution to any problem. And sometimes it's even the problem to any solution, because it's so rich in pigments and coverage. You won't believe it, I really love it. Here you can see me using some washes on the entire model to grime it. Then I'll tackle some details. First the cloth on top, from a brown base to a military green. The seats will go back being red. The first layer of dark red, the second of a lighter tone, then in the end a dark wash on the middle part. The weapon will get a dry brush of my darkest metal color, then a highlight from above of a lighter metal tone. As I said in the start, I know nothing of cars. This is why I made the front light red. No, it felt quite wrong since the start. That helped me realize it. So, after this I painted the backlights in red and the front ones in white. Bravo, Eddie. A British friend of mine suggested I try some contrast paints. Although I don't like them, I can now finally paint yellow things. This is the only yellow color I suggest to everyone to buy. Who has tried using regular yellow knows that use it is impossible as f***. The brown shown before, I'm adding some rust patches. I couldn't get the natural effect if I remember to use the hairspray technique, but, well, it's quite too late. With some bright orange, I'm gonna make some extra layers of rust. It's going over the previous layers, plus some extra recesses. The final touches are the pigments. Due to the blue wax spray paint, they didn't stick as intended, but the result is still good. I'll use the brown in the lower part to mimic the dust from the wasteland, the orange to increase the rust values, and the black to darken the metallic areas. So the car is actually finally complete. After brushing some pigments onto the final details, I will use a transparent matte varnish to protect all the colors, and it's done!
Wow, it's very nice!
So, that's it for the video. If you like it, feel free to press like and subscribe. If you didn't, I don't know why you're still here, but I guess whatever. See you in the next episode, and now I will try to make some justice to this car and try to take some proper picture to it, if I can, I don't know. See you next time, ciao! Good night.